Good morning, one and all. In continuation to the topic from yesterday's water pollution and its case study, today we are going to start with the solid waste. Waste means what? Like, we can see that so, what is this? Now this is a white paper. White paper. Now, what I can do this? We can do anything. We can write. We can draw the diagrams. We can do anything right now. So, this is chalks. What is the use of this? We can write on the board. Now, when I am using this on the board, it is useful for me. But I have just made this small, very small. Now I am trying to write like this. I am making. So once it has come to a position that now I am unable to carry. Now I will just throw it. So it is useless for me right now. So what I am doing, I cannot use further or I cannot utilize that again and again. For that reason, now onwards it is called as waste. So I am throwing that into a dustbin. Whatever it is thrown, whether it is useful or not useful, or whether it is used once again but it is not useful now, which is solid in nature and which is not useful and which goes into the trash, that is dustbin. Dustbin, bin with dust or not required, then that is called as a waste. That is called as a waste. So, generally what type of waste that we can produce from human, from our city, from our village, from our town, from our metro, whatever it is. So, the type of waste that can be produced, which goes into the trash, is called as waste, and it can be paper, it can be textile, it can be cloths, piece of cloths, it can be piece of cloths, it can be metal, it can be metal, it can be metal, it can be leather, it can be leather, it can be also food products. So, these are the different, it can be especially plastics. So, it can be paper with plastic or polyethylene covers. So this is all the categorization of the solid waste will be. So generally, whatever the number, it is basically divided into two things. It is divided into two things. One is called wet waste, one is called dry waste. Wet waste means biological origin. Wet waste means biological origin. Dry waste means chemical or polyethyl waste. So here every waste can be divided into two types: biological origin, which is called wet waste. It may be food, it may be anything related to the human or living origin. And dry waste means chemical or other forms of chemical substances included waste. Included waste. Wet origin, biological origin, dry waste, chemical or polyethyl waste or plastic origin. So here these all chemical substances are again can be of three types. One is, so those who are degradable by the living organisms, produced from living organisms, they are called as biodegradable. Second one is recyclable, means it can be reused again and again. The third is non-biodegradable, non-biodegradable or non-recyclable or single use. Have a note of this. Likewise, human beings are producing two types of waste. One is domestic waste, one is non-biodegradable or recyclable waste. Okay. So here this biodomestic waste also called as biodegradable waste. This all, if that is produced from a municipal corporation like Chikodi, these are all called as municipal waste. They are produced from a municipality, the people living in that area, that is called as a municipal solid waste or municipal waste. So what are the measures generally in this municipality? In the morning only one person will come in the Chikodi by taking a van with song, and they will be saying about that the fever and so on and so on, so many things. So what they are doing? They are collecting waste. Collecting the waste. So that this, that can be from living organisms, and that can be from chemical components. So whatever they are collecting from the living organisms, that is vegetable based, human based and food, others, they are, can be degraded by natural action, by microorganisms. By microorganisms, they will be converted into simpler substances by a process of decomposition into simple components. So these are called as biodegradable, and which are like plastic cover, metal bulbs and so on, they are called as chemical waste. In this, especially plastics and others are called non-biodegradable waste. But the glass, so it is not having much harm to the nature. It may be in the other sense. So leather, paper, it will be disposed of in the environment some year. So only hazards in this is polyethylene or plastic materials, because their lifespan has been approximately expected as 1 lakh years. Means it can stay in the environment up to 1 lakh years from now. If you throw a plastic, and if you can live up to 1 lakh years and see, it will be degraded after 1 lakh years. So the lifespan of the non-biodegradable is there, but it is comparatively very very high than compared to the micro biodegradable. So here we need to think of this, and we need to stop pollution as much as possible. So in this effort, we need to thank RAND Pickers. RAND Pickers means plastic picking ladies or gents and live on picking them. Means they will separate this, so we should be very thankful to the person, because these RAND Pickers are contributing somehow to the environment to stop the pollution. Or they are minimizing, they are at least reducing the by collecting the plastic which are thrown by us, and they are supporting in the controlling some amount of pollution. So in a similar way, when you talk about the next one, petals. When you talk about the petals, so the waste produced from the petals is called as petal waste. So this petal waste contain of cotton scraps, syringes, needles, glucose bottles, glucose bottles and pathogens. So these all can be, most of them, like we have cotton stamps and others, they are biodegradable. Glucose bottles, plastic, most of them can be, but the major issue in them is they are very hazardous. That is, dangerous, very dangerous, because it contains pathogens. This is causing microorganisms so what is the solution for them? So here, disposing them correctly is also one of the major issues. So in order to control them, we need to use incinerators. So these are the gas burn chambers. Which are maintained at the which are maintained at 400 to 900 degrees centigrade in this hospital waste is introduced. And they are burnt. So at high temperature. So here, this is how we can reduce some hospital waste. We can produce some measures for controlling the hospital waste also, to prevent the pollution at some levels, and also this is free society. And the next one of the important waste is, e-waste. Devices called e-waste. Waste produced from irreparable parts of the electronic devices of computers is called e-waste. So waste means which goes into the trash. So then why the e-waste is coming? Because America is almost sending 20 billion tons every year to three countries. You remember the three countries in the order? Communist Party of India, CPI. Here C means China, P means Pakistan, and I, India. So these three are the importers of the e-waste from America. Only America per year approximately 20 billion tons is sending to these three countries. Why? So here the these countries, the China, Pakistan and India, they are importing this because we will get 5 important metals from that. C, S, I, N, G. Singapore or CC. C stands for the copper. S stands for the I stands for the N stands for the nickel. G stands for the gold. I stands for the here C stands for the copper. S stands for the silicon. I stands for the iron. N stands for the nickel and gold. So this will be recovered during recycling. But during the process of recycling, improper recycling measures, they are seeping into soil and causing seeping of water not useful for drinking. Water not useful for drinking and also heavy metal, into soil. This is how it is damaging the quality of water and air. In the case study of soil pollution, a person in Bangalore by name Ahmed Khan, 54 years. So, as per this book, 2002. This was 2002 in the year. From 2002, it was 54. He was 54 years. So what he used to do means, he used to collect the plastic for 6 rupees per kg of plastic. Earlier it was 0.6 rupee per kg. Means that is 60 paisa per kg. So this plastic was converted into polyblend. Means it is a fine powder of plastic. Okay. So he has prepared his own blend called polyblend. To this, this polyblend was added with a chemical substance called butamine. And this is used to lay roads. So this Ahmed Khan, to convert this, taken the help of a college in Bangalore called RV College of Engineering. RV College of Engineering, both combinedly created this. Ahmed Khan plus RV Engineering College laid 40 kilometer roads around Bangalore, where the lifespan of the roads was comparatively increased. So this is one of the suggestions for plastic waste utilization. So for this is a 3-mark question, 2020 PU March. In the 2020 PU paper, to March examination, it came for 3-mark in 5-mark question. As I expected, I was set. So here the chances is the polybutene butamine and the NEET college are very important. They can ask the NEET bit from this question. NEET bit from this particular question. So we'll see the next part.